Hi, and welcome to Lyne RC. Today, we're going to show how to mount a motor and ESC in a touring car. This is the Express XQ1 touring car, and we're going to mount a motor like this one, the Hobbywing XR10 U-Stock 7.5-ton brushless sensored motor. This is a motor specially made for racing, and it's the motor we are required to use in our racing class. So, we have touring car here, just like the other one, and we're going to mount a motor in this one. So, here we have the motor. We have another box with the ESC, and another box with the motor. So, it's a nice small motor. A small ESC, of course, and you can see it's brushless and it's sensored. There's a fan and also a capacitor. And in the box we also get something to mount it with and some heat shrink, cable tie, user manual and some stickers. Very nice looking motor. We also get the sensor cable. There's two, long and a short one. And a user manual. When it's a sensor motor, it's very important that we connect A on the motor to A on the ESC and B to B and C to C. For a non-sensored motor doesn't matter, it just will change the rotation of the motor, but for a sensored system like this it's very important that A go to A and B to B, etc. Else it will not work. So to mount the motor we need a couple of screws that matches the motor here and make sure they're not too long. We also need a pinion that of course match your spur gear. And in our case, we need a total gearing of 5.5 because that's what the rule says. So we are gonna use a 116 tooth spur gear and a 40 tooth pinion. The motor is strong enough for a higher gearing, but that's not allowed in our race class. Before we mount the motor, we need to figure out how to mount it. Because we want to mount it in a way so we have an easy and simple way of making the cables as from the ESC to the motor as short as possible. So this is how I did it last time, so I'll just do the same. So make sure you don't mount the motor like this or another way which makes the cabling more difficult. Exactly where to mount the pinion, line it up with the spur gear. So, and then it's time to. It's important to have the right mesh between the gears, not too tight, not too loose, should be room for a little play. Use some plate cleaner. I'm going to mount the ESC. Yeah, I forgot to mount the sensor cable on the ESC before I mounted the ESC, so I just had to take out the motor again, so I could mount the sensor cable in here. Nope, not a big deal. I just mount the motor again. To test. See if it works. And we are now ready to go to the track for racing. Thanks for watching. See you next time.